These are the lengths that I go to fucking make a video these days. Go on my shitty ass first edition iPhone to find the topics for Tranny Star. Let's cut and redo this, okay? Because they're gonna be like, this is, we're supposed to build this shit up. Hey, I'm supposed to introduce you. To do all that kind of crap. Such a bad host. Like, when I bring you to all these people that you probably already know. Hi, everyone. How you doing?
How you doing?
This is my lovely BF, Aaron. Say hi.
Hey, hey, hey.
This is the one that I've been oogling over for a very long time now, and I mean like a few weeks, but hey, that in my mind, that's a long time.
Mm-hmm. Feels like a long time.
It does feel like a long time. Yeah. I think, and I believe, and I don't care if you agree or not, you meet people in this lifetime that you just feel like you have known for a long time. As cliche as it may sound, I think it does happen. And maybe if we reincarnate, we probably know each other, you know, in last lives, you were a dog, and I was a fire hydrant. We're in a water sports.
Right.
Not really. The topic this week is set by Kayden, and reads as follows. What is one thing you want to improve about yourself? I'm perfect in every way.
Yeah.
All right, next question. No,
physical or, you know, anything?
I took this question as, like, yourself as in who you are, probably more personality-wise, but I guess it could be interpreted on all different levels. I've changed so much in the last 6.5-7 months of my life that I don't know if I can really answer this question because I'm still getting acquainted to myself as a changed person, which isn't just because of transition at all. It's transition has facilitated a lot of the ways that I've changed. And when I say changed, it's not like I was a bad person beforehand. I'm just saying growing as a person. I'm so, I think, creative, you know, it becomes, like, my life becomes a little bit delusional. I hate being realistic. I hate being that, you know, the hard truths of the world all the time. But I think that hinders me sometimes because then I tend not to do some of the mundane things that we have to do here, and I procrastinate with them because I don't value certain things as important as other things, like what is sitting right next to me, you know, rather than making a bajillion dollars. It's just always been harder for me, so it's like I'm working from backwards, like I'm coming from developing and, you know, mentally and emotionally, and now I'm trying to develop into, you know, work in the physical world, where many people start in the physical world and then develop mentally and emotionally, so it's kind of weird, but that's probably where I'm at, that I could improve. And now he has like a minute and a half to speak, probably, because I took up all the fucking time. So what do you think that you can improve in yourself?
I would like to be more assertive and self-confident.
Yeah. Can you expand on that? I mean, that's pretty cut and dry.
Yeah, that's pretty cut and dry.
But, so the kitty is wee-weeing a lot. I think that you're a sweet, 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 sweet individual. And not just like sweet, but like, you know, a sweetheart. And you have a lot to say. I know you do. And I think that if you could find a way to, you know, verbalize it in your own way, it'd really benefit, like, the community and yourself and everyone around you. What is something that you love about yourself? you want me to go first? You want to go first?
Okay.
Is there time to be assertive?
Oh.
Ooh, assertiveness.
I like my insightfulness. I think I'm a pretty insightful person.
Mm-hmm.
And creative. Yeah. I like to make things.
Right. What do you like making?
All sorts of things. I like to do stuff on Photoshop and design things and play with clay.
So three-dimensional, all kind of mediums.
Yeah.
I'm asking questions, but I know that you are very creative and I see all your creativity. I think that's one of the reasons why we really bond is because we understand that. I think you're a very insightful person, and I think to be insightful, I think that takes creativity.
Mm-hmm.
To a certain extent. Kiss number like 5 on this video. It's a hot video. I think I've recently, and this is a more recent thing that I really love about myself, and it's something that I've kind of just, it's one of those growing things I was talking about earlier. For the longest time I used to isolate myself from people. And because of, as we all get screwed over in life and whatever, you know, just a lot of stuff happened, just like to everyone else, things happen. And, you know, I push people away and I alienated myself. And ever since transition, I've had to depend on other people and for certain things of just support. And then being on YouTube, you know, I think has really helped too. For the first time in my life, I feel like I'm part of something bigger. And I feel like it's okay to trust people again, no matter how much may be at stake, which is a big step for me because I would push people away. I would end friendships or just keep people at arm's length. And I'm letting that go because you can live, you know, your life alone and always holding on to those feelings that are just going to destroy you, or you can let them go and actually live life and live it for everything that it is, and that's not always good, but just live it and feel it all. So it's nice to actually be living. I feel like I'm actually living now, you know, for better or for worse, and actually feeling everything, and it's nice to be feel human. I think we're both not used to making videos with other people in the videos, but if anyone was to be in my videos, I want to be you.
Likewise.
So, I hope everyone has a wonderful weekend. I hope you keep your underwear on or
wear off.
But, I'll check you later.